you know, the grand jury is sort of this mystery, right, to people, and it's written right into our Constitution. So really, it shouldn't be a mystery, but it is. You know, the Bill of Rights calls for a grand jury in felony cases, and that allows the prosecutor to present its evidence to a neutral party, whether it's the grand jury or a judge in a preliminary hearing, to show that there's two things. One, that there's probable cause that a crime has been committed, and probable cause that this is the individual who committed the crime. So at a trial, we have to prove, you know, beyond a reasonable doubt, you know, to a moral certainty that the person charged is the defendant who committed the crime. But again, in the grand jury, it's just probable cause. In order for the case to go to a trial, the grand jury would have had to have, obviously I wasn't there, but presumably they would have voted a true bill saying that there was probable cause to move forward. So a grand jury is somewhat mysterious, I think, to the general public. Another reason that is it's secret. And, you know, that actually, I think some people get concerned with that. It's actually supposed to be a protection for the defendant. And the idea there is, you know, if the grand jury decides that there's not probable cause, that the person should not have the stigma of, you know, having been, you know, brought before a grand jury. And, you know, the disclosure of secret grand jury material can be a crime in jurisdictions. And it's certainly unethical for a prosecutor to disclose things that happen in the grand jury, and the grand jurors themselves can't disclose. Now, the witnesses in New York are free to talk about what they presented to the grand jury.
What flashed into my mind just now was the room that we were waiting in. The ADA came in and called me in to testify. I walk in, I sit down, I look around the room. I see nobody who looks like me. No person of color. They were sitting in an area like a theater, elevated seats. There must have been 20-something people there. One person was reading a book, another lady was reading a magazine. There was a conversation going on. My feelings were, when I sat in that chair, was, they don't care about what I have to say. They really don't. They weren't paying attention. They weren't, okay? And I became very angry with myself, because at one point I began to cry, and I hated that moment because I felt that, you know, they were going to say, here is another black woman who didn't do her job with her child, and now she wants us to make somebody pay. That's how I felt. When your father came back, he said to me, don't expect anything, because it ain't gonna happen.
And how did you find out what they had decided?
They came here.
Who came here?
One ADA and a detective.
And what did they tell you?
They didn't indict. They returned no true bill.
That was it?
I'm sorry.
What happened after that?
I opened the door and said, thank you for coming. And I will be very honest with you. When that door closed, I collapsed.